Scratch is an amazing tool for bringing stories to life. Just add a few movement commands and toss in a little dialogue, and it's easy to make your sprites talk to each other. But getting them to listen is a whole other story. So the problem we're trying to solve here is how to get sprites to take turns doing actions and saying dialogue. The simple solution is to add one or two of these wait blocks to get one character to wait before it does its thing. This works fine for simple stories, but once your code gets a little longer, you'll discover that making changes in one sprite can mess up the choreography across your whole project. A more reliable way to control timing is to use message blocks. Message blocks work a little like a walkie-talkie, passing hidden messages back and forth between two sprites. Let's start by creating a little scene where one sprite tells a joke to his buddy. After our cat walks across the screen and says his first line, let's pull out a broadcast block from the orange events blocks and add it to our cat's code. Okay, we've sent message one. Now we need to get our other character, the bat, to listen for the cat's message with this event block called When I Receive Message 1. Let's add a little dialogue and click the green flag. As you can see, the bat doesn't execute its code until after the cat is finished talking. Now let's go back to the bat and create a new message. We'll call it Message 2 to tell the cat it's his turn again. Keep adding new message blocks to continue the story. Notice that each sequence of commands is sandwiched between two blocks, a receive block that starts the action, and a broadcast block that tells the next actor it's his turn to do something. Okay, let's look at our finished joke.
I feel the liftoff. The clock has started. Roger.